Next Generation Meteorologist Joe Shaka here from Patreon.com and YouTube, looking at our tropical update for September 24th, 2021. And today, we'll be looking at Hurricane Sam, which is right down here, winds of 75 miles per hour and continuing to move off to the west at 15 miles an hour. I didn't make a track and intensity forecast for this thing because it's not going to really be any impact to any major land areas that I certainly do not believe, so I didn't want to spend extra time creating an intensity forecast for something that will be pretty much over the ocean for its entire life. However, though, if the need needs to change, there will certainly be a track and intensity forecast for this. But the track and intensity for this is, I'd say, it's slam dunk. So let's take a look at what's going on here. So here's the European MJO. You can see we're on the borderline of phase 4 and 5, the null phase. And we're going to be coming, it looks like, out and around into phase 4 and 5 over the next week or so, and then maybe into its 6 and 7. In the first few days of the month of October. So there's the European and the JMA with a similar look over the next several days here going down the road into the beginning of October. Phase 4 and 5, you know, that's actually a pretty good correlation, as I've been saying there, you know, where Sam's are going to be coming up, a little bit of a negative correlation, then some more positive correlations along the East Coast, and then as this feature turns out, it'll be going into those negative areas, but the system at that time is going to be a well-developed major hurricane, so it's not going to really matter about these blue areas anymore. It's more for development. Now that we've got a system going, that doesn't matter as much. But look at that, phase 6 and 7 off the New England coast to maybe the first week of October with that cutoff low that may be developing. A very interesting situation as this whole steering pattern begins to evolve. If we're in phase 6 and 7 with this cutoff low that may be happening, which is going to take, looks like, Sam out, could be some homebrew activity. So that would be interesting once we get Sam by us. So here are the ocean temperature anomalies. You can see very warm in the path of what Sam is going to be following. So that's certainly not a limiting factor. Actual ocean temperatures look like this, pretty much 80 degrees, still up to 40 degrees north. So certainly that's a big positive for Sam as well. Japanese vertical velocity for this upcoming week, which begins tomorrow. Sam will be remaining in a neutral to positive upward motion pattern. You can see the JMA with the enhanced rainfall here, as it turns out, somewhere out by Bermuda. Here comes this trough split. It starts here and then it continues on in week 2, which is going to kick this out. Sam comes up. The westerlies are moving off to the northeast, so it will come up, feel that steering, and then take that northeast turn. Very, very confident in that. And again, you can see that in the precipitation anomalies for week 1. Week 2, even more bullish day. You can see that classic signal as the tropical cyclone goes out. Here is the trough split. A piece goes off. Sam is likely taken off well into the North Atlantic at this time. And then here's some other fun and games closer to the U.S. East Coast. Week 2 with the MJO, again, being in that phase 6 and 7. Will be interesting in time. So here is the 0Z European tracks. You can see many of them avoiding the islands. And again, these are the intensities. So you can see a lot of these purples and pinks, 80 to 100 knots plus. So this is certainly no question going to be a high-end Category 4. May even make a shot at Category 5 hurricane north of the islands here as we get into early next week. And as it is, the models are initializing 2 weeks, but that's expected with the global resolution. But nevertheless, it doesn't impact the track because, again, of this trough that's coming on in. But you can definitely see that the turn up to the north and then eventually northeast with the island of Bermuda, possibly a greatest threat for impact with the system. Here's the 6C GEFS. You can see even the GEFS is further east now than the European with the potential impacts, if any, for the island of Bermuda and then making that northeast easterly turn with that trough. Now, I'll escape here because I'm not able to pause, so I'd like to walk through this here if it will let me. Okay, so here we are. This is Valen late tomorrow night, early Sunday morning. This is 2 a.m. Eastern Sunday. Here's where Sam is going to be. You can see this large-scale ridging. Here comes the beginning of this whole trough split situation over the Great Lakes. And as we continue to move through here, it looks like it's going to reset itself. Okay, let's see what happens over here. So as we get into Sunday here afternoon, here comes that trough split, here comes the storm. It's going to reset every time I'll do it, so I guess I can't pause it. Otherwise, we're going to be going through it again. But anyway, here comes that trough split. It's going slow enough. I can do this. So here comes Sam. This comes up. So that piece goes out. Then you can see this piece is left behind over the East Coast. Sam is on the field. That here's that subtropical ridge. Here's that trough right in through here. And then because of the flow around this trough, it comes up, curves it out as it's sandwiched in between the mid North Atlantic Ridge and this trough that's off the East Coast, most likely going to be a cutoff low, which is what the operational European and other operational guidance has been showing over the last couple of days. And now you can see some other feature possibly developing and coming back inland. But mainly the theme here is this turns up and goes out, thankfully, not a threat to the East Coast, but may get close to Newfoundland down the road, but or maybe even Nova Scotia. But again, highest threat would certainly be Bermuda, and of course, the northern part of the islands and the Caribbean as we get into early next week. So let me just pause this one more time as we get into this frame. Okay, so here we go. Here it is, the large-scale ridging, the shortwave cutoff trough, and the storm coming up and around. I'll loop that one more time. So I want to make the point clear here. This is not going to be a U.S. threat. I know a lot of people are saying, still going to watch out for the East Coast, but I disagree with that, given what you just see here. So let's loop this one more time. Coming up and around, here's that cutoff trough split situation, and the position of the trough sends it out, weakness in the ridge, and it is the ocean storm. And then finally going over here, from this is the ensemble mean, from the European, you can see same kind of thing here with that nice trough split, cutoff trough situation happening here. Very nicely showing up here. Here's the tropical cyclone, and there's the weakness in the ridge off the northeast of that. So that explains the Alpha Sea. And then tropical development over the next couple of weeks continue to remain quite favorable in this part of the world. So that's it for now, and thank you for watching.